I am about to announce a breakthrough in self-healing. I've been working on research for several months that's called biosynthesis, and it uses certain botanical extracts that have a specific molecular structure to end cap or encapsulate certain, we'll say elemental ions. And the combination creates a powerful anti-tumorigenic medicine. And more importantly, you can make it yourself. There's a specific process to make it. And I'm going to share that with you. I'm going to release that to the world. I'm going to do it through the patent office. Now, that may sound counterintuitive, but a lot of people don't truly understand how patents work. Many people think that when you patent something, that it keeps it secret from the public. That's not true at all. In fact, to get a patent, you have to disclose exactly how it's made. You have to disclose the procedure for making it or how it works. You know, you can get a process patent or you can get a substance patent, things like that. But the patent itself has to describe step by step how you make this. And my goal with patenting this is to release it to the public and prohibit anyone else from locking it up and claiming intellectual property over this technique. So I'm going to patent it and release it to the world through the patent office. Now, why does this matter to you? Well, this is a super low-cost method. I mean, it's insanely low cost. It's going to allow entire communities or families to make their own anti-cancer medicine at home and to give it away or charge very little for it. I mean, the ingredients are incredibly inexpensive and the process is relatively simple. It requires a couple of pieces of low-cost equipment. I'm estimating that the total cost for the equipment that you need is under, let's say, well, it could be under $250, but certainly under $500, kind of depending on what level of gear you want in order to make this. But the steps are very, very important, the procedure. If you have the same ingredients, but you do it in the wrong order, it won't turn out correctly. You won't have the final product that is anti-cancer. So you have to do it in these certain steps. And I'm going to release all that step by step. And my intention is to film a video and have an article with photos and all of this. Now all of this may sound alien to you if you're used to corporations being based on greed and monopolistic pharmaceutical pricing and things like that. You might say, well, gosh, Mike, why would you give this away to the world when you could make a fortune selling it? Because I think that decentralization of knowledge is how we uplift humanity. I think the more people know this secret recipe, you might say, the better off we all are. And it's not, I don't like monopolies. I don't think it's even ethical to try to monopolize knowledge that could help save people from disease and suffering. It should be openly shared. That's why I also believe there should be no patents allowed on pharmaceuticals. And again, the only reason I'm patenting this is just to document the method so that it can be shared with the world and prevent anybody else from locking it down. But the way pharmaceutical companies work is they patent something for the purpose of denying other people the right to manufacture that. So they patent for an evil purpose, to centralize control and monopolize control over medicine. I'm patenting for the opposite purpose, which is to release it to the world. But I'm also going to manufacture it and sell it. You know, you have to guess, I suppose, what I'm selling that is this product. But I am going to offer it for sale without the claims, just as a nutritional supplement. But you can make it and you can know what it really does. Now, let me back up and talk about the research for a minute here, because I want to give some credit too. Now, the way I came up with this is by reading a lot of science papers. I was reading science papers on nanoparticles and biosynthesis based on green chemistry. Now, green chemistry means doing organic chemistry without using toxic substances. It's an entire area of study now in the sciences. And, you know, because of all the concern about pollution, environmental contamination of toxic chemicals and so on, a lot of people are doing work on green chemistry. And then there's a lot of pharmaceutical work on nanoparticle creation using biosynthesis. A biosynthesis simply means that you're creating molecules using biology or using, in this case, plant molecules, you know, plant biology or botany. And there are many papers that exist. And I will cite these, by the way, in my patent. So I'll be giving credit to these scientists. And some of them are, well, most of them are outside the United States. I found that quite fascinating that U.S. scientists aren't looking at this very closely, but outside the US in places like Spain and Italy, a lot of European countries, they're doing great research on this. So I must have read, I don't know, 25 science papers, something like that now. And I went through all these science papers and they were talking about nanoparticle creation through biosynthesis using different methods and different molecules, different pH values, all kinds of different approaches. And most of the papers were interested in this because nanoparticles are considered to be a drug delivery mechanism for big pharma. So most of this research is taking place in order to try to create nanoparticles that would be licensed or sold to pharmaceutical companies that could encapsulate drugs that would be delivered to tumors. So in other words, a pharmaceutical company would take, let's say, an anti-cancer chemotherapy agent that is highly toxic, and they would that would consist of, let's say, a liquid of a bunch of these molecules, and then they would do a nano-encapsulation procedure by combining it with usually very toxic substances to create, you know, nanoscale particles, which are their drugs surrounded by these other, sometimes like a glycine or sometimes, you know, different active molecular groups, let's say, groups that would be recognized by your organs in your body. And, you know, glycine is one of them. Like, you've seen this with minerals, for example, orotate. You know, you've seen these different groups with like calcium supplements and magnesium supplements and so on. But what Big Pharma is trying to do is have their drugs attached to these to deliver them to specific targets in your body, such as your liver if you have liver cancer, or, you know, your pancreas if you have pancreatic cancer and so on. So the idea in the mind of Big Pharma is to have specific receptor site targeted drugs that deliver payloads, which are nanoparticles surrounded by biologically compatible outside molecular groups, we'll say. And that's a valid concept, by the way. If they were to deliver chemotherapy that way, they could use a lot less chemotherapy, because right now chemotherapy carpet bombs the entire body, which is insane. But what if you could deliver chemotherapy directly to the organ that has the tumor? Well, that's what Big Pharma is working on. So they've done a lot of research into this. Well, I was thinking, what if we delivered natural anti-cancer substances to these tumors instead of toxic chemotherapy that's developed from mustard gas chemicals of World War I, which is what Big Pharma does? And so that's what led me down this path, thinking, you know, gosh, if Big Pharma can do this, you know, I have a lab, we've got instruments, you know, we're pretty clever, we can figure this out. So that's what led me down this path. And sure enough, a few months into it, I did figure it out. I was basically taking what I learned from these papers, but then augmenting it and doing a lot of trial and error. And I found a lot of, by the way, mistakes in the papers. That's one thing. When you're an actual lab scientist like I am, and you'll find that most of the science papers that are published out there are just full of errors. It's crazy. Like if you try to read a method on how to do chromatography, let's say, or mass spec chromatography on some specific targeted analyte, and you read the paper and it tells you a method, you know, oh, you mix your methanol with, you know, 5 millimolar ammonium formate and spike it with formic acid and then have a reverse phase gradient to aqueous solution and blah, blah, blah. And it goes through this, use this column and use these masses and use these voltages on your fragmenter and all this stuff. You go through that, most of the time it doesn't work because most of these papers are full of errors. It's really insane. So what I've learned over the years is that the paper can be a starting point, but you have to apply like your own science knowledge, and you have to do a whole bunch of trial and error. And that's what I did. So over many, many experiments, I came up with the way to do this, which is to very inexpensively and very easily, using very low-tech equipment. I mean, this could be done in a third world country as long as you've got some electricity. It does require some electricity, but not much. But you could make anti-cancer medicine. It's amazing. And it's a very simple technique. I mean, I can't quite describe it right here in a podcast. It does have many steps, so I will document it, and it'll be in the patent as well. But it's so simple. I remember thinking, gosh, everybody should have this. People should be making this in their homes. Why should anybody suffer from cancer when there are such readily available anti-cancer solutions? But of course, then you also see lots of attacks on natural medicine. You know, remember the big thing about MMS, for example? What was it called? Miracle Mineral Solution, I think. And it was viciously attacked because, well, it was effective. It was helping people, and it was treating Ebola in Africa, for example. And it was working. It was curing people of malaria and things like that. So, of course, the FDA went after it, the FTC and everybody went after it, you know, the UN, the WHO. So they'll probably do the same for what I'm about to reveal as well, which doesn't yet have a name, but I'll come up with a name for it before I release it. But they'll probably attack it. But see, that's the point of decentralizing it, so that once you have the recipe, it doesn't matter if they attack it. They try to censor it, you already have the recipe. In fact, millions of people will have the recipe. And the reason I'm stating all this now is because I'm getting a lot of death threats. And I think that this project, frankly, is one of the most important contributions to humanity that I will ever make. And I want to get this on the record that I'm working on this and that I'm trying to get this out to the world while we still have a chance, you know, to have some freedom of speech, or before they try to take me out. You know, the cancer industry doesn't want people to halt cancer. They want people to have cancer. And will they kill people for their profits to protect their corporate revenues? You bet they will. So, you know, don't think that we live in a world where a big pharma plays by the rules. They absolutely do not play by the rules. They will kill people. They will have people, you know, discredited, murdered, threatened, blackmailed, whatever they can do. And they've tried a lot of those things against me, and they just haven't succeeded, which is why I'm still here doing my science, sharing these discoveries with the world, publishing naturalnews.com, and, you know, just basically driving them nuts with all the things that we're doing. So wait until I release this, man. They're going to pull their hair out and go insane, especially when the patent comes out. Like, oh my God, it's another patent from the Health Ranger. How is he doing this? The answer is I'm just working, and I'm sharing these discoveries with the world, and I care about humanity. I want people to be healthy. I want people to be free. I want knowledge to be decentralized, widely distributed, and I want humanity to have this technology, unlike the pharmaceutical companies that wants to keep humanity enslaved in a cycle of disease and debt and destitution and government-run healthcare and all that garbage. I'd rather you never need pharmaceuticals. I'd rather show you how to make your medicine yourself. So, by the way, this is perfectly legal to make. There's nothing illegal in this process, and there's nothing hazardous in terms of there are no explosive gases or high pressures or super high temperatures or anything like that. It's easy to make, and it's cool. You can watch it happening right in front of your own eyes. The nanoparticle biosynthesis actually happens as you're watching it. You can actually see it. It's crazy. I've got video of it already. I have a microscope at the lab. We took video of this biosynthesis happening in real time, and it was mind-blowing. And we've got a lot more coming on this, including electron microscopy. So I'll keep it posted on this, but you know, keep reading naturalnews.com. This is coming out. It's just a question of when. I don't know exactly when, but hopefully soon. Humanity needs this. Thank you for your support. And if you want to support our online store, by the way, where we have nutritional supplements and superfoods for human health, go to healthrangerstore.com. The more that you shop there, frankly, the more funding we have for our in-house laboratory, and the more room I have, so to speak, to do projects like this for humanity, to release more knowledge that can help save lives and help end human suffering. And that's a big part of what I do. I thank you for your support. This is Mike Adams here, the Health Ranger. When it comes to real science behind nutritional supplements and personal care products, even superfoods and nutrients, nobody pays as much attention to what's in your products as we do at healthrangerstore.com. We have an in-house laboratory, ISO accredited. We do mass spec testing for heavy metals, herbicides like glyphosate, bacteria, microbiology testing, including E. coli and salmonella, yeast and mold, and others. We do extensive testing, and we reject 80% of the raw materials lots that we test. And we only use the top 20% that pass our stringent requirements for ultra clean food, supplements, personal care products, and green living home products like eco-friendly laundry detergent, body soaps, dishwasher detergent, things for your home, things for your body, things that are good for the environment and good for you, and that we can verify through our science. Because our position is we don't trust any supplier of raw materials. We've been in this industry for long enough to know that there's all kinds of organic fraud, counterfeit certifications, fake claims, and just a lack of basic testing out there. Heavy metals inundate the supply of superfoods, and even organics often will contain glyphosate and other toxic herbicides and pesticides. That's why we do this testing. We've learned not to trust any source in the industry, and that it takes determined, consistent testing to produce clean products, and that's why people shop with us. That's why we have over 100,000 customers at healthrangerstore.com who have come to trust us, to trust our lab testing, to know that we provide the world's cleanest foods, supplements, and superfoods using today's best science, the best, the most expensive scientific instruments in the world, triple quad mass spectrometry, ICP-MS for heavy metals analysis. We also have single quad mass specs and other instruments, time of flight, tandem mass spec time of flight instrument, and other things. To get our lab tested products, just go to healthrangerstore.com/science. That's healthrangerstore.com/science. There you'll find hundreds of products that have been laboratory tested, verified for your safety and efficacy and product honesty. Again, that URL, type it into your browser, is healthrangerstore.com/science. We do extensive testing like no one. No one does this, and especially not Amazon, where they sell products that are loaded with toxic lead and high levels of aluminum that are off the charts that you can't even believe. I mean, if you want to eat lead and aluminum, buy supplements from Amazon. But if you want good science-backed clean food and clean supplements, you get that from healthrangerstore.com. That's what people have come to know us for providing, and that's why people keep coming back to us. We are dedicated to this testing, and we continue to make investments in our laboratory facilities to bring you the cleanest, most verified nutritional products in the world. No one else does what we do. No one. We are leading the world in clean food. And you can take advantage of that right now at healthrangerstore.com. I'm Mike Adams, the Health Ranger. I thank you for your support. There's much more to come. The more you support us, the more we can produce content to help educate the world and uplift people through natural solutions based on nutrition and superfoods, disease prevention, cognitive enhancement, anti-aging technology, and much more. Thank you for your support. Thank you for watching. If you want to support our mission, visit us at healthrangerstore.com for the world's largest selection of lab-verified superfood and nutritional products for healthy living. It's at healthrangerstore.com.